Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Court of Swords. I believe this is week 30. I think we're the we're old now officially. That's when you get old.
Is that when
really?
You get
old? Yeah, I'm 30 years old. I'm old. I can't. This is confirmation based on life facts. True facts. It sucks.
I don't think we're old at all.
You're like 22 or some shit. For
yeah,
some
quiet
reason.
You.
Yeah. Max, aren't 22. You like 24 or something? Or don't you look like super old, but you're like 5 years old or something?
Yes.
You're getting younger every time he opens his
mouth. Oh, that is correct.
And every you're time. Two.
Aren't you like 18 or some shit?
Aren't you 12?
Max, you're 24 though, right, Max?
No, I'm 26.
Oh my god. Oh shit. Maybe yeah, I just was actually
you're
adding.
A real person.
You're pretty old.
I'm not, you know, I'm not young, but I'm not. Well, I am young in terms of it all depends where you're coming from, I guess.
Yeah.
Everyone just assumes I'm older.
There's this incredibly narrow window. There's a narrow window between not being a teenage fuck up anymore and feeling like you're old. Like it's so thin. Like it's usually like a year or so. Like you're 25, you're like, all right, I kind of got my shit together. You turn 26, you're like, God, I might as well be dead. Like I'm just gonna go lie down.
Yeah.
Well, honestly, for me, it's like, I didn't grow up celebrating my birthdays really, because we just didn't. So I feel like I've talked about it with my brother, like everybody else that I talk to, like makes such a big emphasis on their birthdays. And I feel like that's part of the reason why it's every time it is their birthday, they're like, holy shit, I'm this age. But for me and my brother, it's always been like, well, another year older, you know, like kind of deal. And we still get that every now and then, like, you know, feeling like, oh, fuck, where does the time go kind of deal. But I don't think like it's as dramatic as a lot of other like normal, I guess, society is in celebrating birthdays, because most people do make a big deal about it. Some people don't, you know, but we just never made a big thing of it. And plus, everyone's always thought I was older because he's 6 years older than me and I've always hung out with him. So I kind of always hung out with his friends.
Yeah.
So as a residual of that, or as a result of that, people always just kind of assume that I'm older, just because I guess I have that disposition about myself.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Now we know why Max thinks. I don't know why we went off. It's great tangent. Good tangents.
I'm sorry.
No. I started
I won't
it.
Talk. I won't
I
like talk.
I started this. You don't need to apologize at all. This is my fault.
This is what we do on Court of Swords. We bait Max into talking about stuff and then give him shit for talking about it.
God damn it, Max.
That's the thing that happens when you get older, JP. You just start to babble. You
yeah,
know?
I know.
Lay them along.
I know.
All right, I'm
I
done
do
talking.
Like getting the wisdom about aging from like the 26-year-old. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
I have more than 10 years on you. I am 38.
I
so
wasn't
you guys
to
now,
start
I don't. Is Adam?
You should all listen to your elder.
I think
here.
Adam's like 40, right? Adam, how old are you?
I'm 33.
Oh, okay. You're. Okay. All
right. That's why I make fun of wheat so hard, is because you just pick the person who's older than you and just like aim all at them. That's why wheat picks.
Wheat's
on
almost 40.
And Scoots has no one to pick on because he's older than dirt.
Yeah.
So, fine. There's
I think Scoots things. Almost 50.
No.
Yeah. I don't know much about ages though. I just know thereabouts the big number. I don't know exact numbers for anyone, so. Let's ask more random questions here at the top of the show, because it's been like 3 days. We have nothing to talk about for the next 5 or 10 minutes.
I haven't done anything in the past 3 days.
Yeah, I haven't. Yeah.
I
haven't
actually
either.
Haven't really.
The only thing either. That I've done is showered every day, and thus I asked Dan's Gaming a question. Dan, do you use shampoo?
I find that offensive.
Is it offensive? I was sitting there and I was like, man, I wonder what other type
Why
of shampoo. Because I buy a lot of shampoo. I found out yesterday that I have a problem. I just buy shampoo. If I go to the store for like, oh man, I need some paper plates, or I don't know. I need random grocery item thing today. Let's go to the shampoo aisle and buy some shampoo. So then I started thinking, does Dan actually use shampoo? So I need to know, Dan. I need to know.
Yeah, I use shampoos not as much as someone with a full head of hair, you know, just mostly to wash the scalp.
That's
and there's a little bit of hair up here. It's not a lot, but it's a little bit.
I feel like it's got to feel real good having a shaved head and shampooing it. Am I wrong?
I guess.
God damn it, man.
I would use soap better. For sure. Cause...
Yeah, shampoo is for hair. There's other products for skin. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh.
Like, would you like bar
same,
soap,
I don't
or what would you
use?
I
shampoo on my head as I do on my beard. There's two
Wait,
different
okay.
products there.
There are. So, is it like beard shampoo?
There is beard shampoo, yeah.
Oh, the internet. all over the place.
The thing that the thing that sucks about beard shampoo, though, at least in my experiences, is that it just breaks my skin out like all over the place if I use it because it's too oily. It's all fucking oil based.
It's supposed to be moisturizing.
Yeah, it's supposed to like help the beard be more.
I think it depends because a lot of beard shampoo is really just like moisturizer for your face.
Yeah,
and they don't really care about the beard because I think most people's beards are like max length, like short.
Yeah,
not really like because me like there's lots of beard that isn't even touching my face, so it's a totally different thing.
Yep.
But yeah, different kind of hair, same as how skin is not hair.
Yeah.
So. But Dan, if you want to rub shampoo on your head. Don't let me stop you. You do whatever you want.
I like the
man.
Smell of the shampoo I use.
That's what I'm saying. What do you use? We're just going to ask everyone now. Dan, what do you use? What type of shampoo?
Old Spice Men's. It's really, really nice. It has caffeine in it, too, so it helps wake me up.
What?
Does that actually work?
Is that a
caffeine
thing?
Caffeine can be absorbed through the skin, yes.
Are they targeting, like, the Doritos generation with that? Like,
you realize when you say the Doritos generation, you're talking about yourself, right?
No, like, I'm not the Doritos
generation.
You're
in that demographic.
No, I'm not. I'm 30.
They had Doritos when I was growing up, too. You know this.
Doritos have been around since, like, when? The 70s, all right? So technically anyone born since the 70s is the Doritos generation.
Now, Morgan, I'm just imagining you in, like, a bunch of petticoats holding a paper bag with, like, yon Doritos written upon it.
Ye olde Doritos. Yeah, exactly.
When were Doritos made? 1964.
Carriage.
They were.
See, we had Doritos until the Kaiser took them from us. So
they were nationwide in 66.
Yeah.
What is what? I want to look at some Doritos original packaging. But before we do that, Gassy, while you're eating, tell me what type of
you don't want to know about. I mean, it's young hip kid shit. You don't.
What? No, that's the stuff I like. I don't. Yeah. When people say Old Spice, I roll my eyes. When people say, like, fuck, it's some crazy argan oil Moroccan bullshit, I'm like, oh, yeah, tell me more. Let's talk about it.
I was just doing the bit of being quiet.
Okay.
To go back, beard shampoo. Use Kalamazoo if you guys want from Lush.
See, that's
really
what
good.
Breaks
that's
me out.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
That's what I use. Ooh. I have, like, 4 tubs of it, and I don't use it because it just breaks
it's really
skin
good.
Out.
It breaks it's out your skin?
Yeah, it makes my face feel fucking oily. I don't like
that's
it.
Really send, surprising.
Send that shit my way, dude.
You're supposed to wash it off. You know that, right? Like you don't just
yes,
like rub
man,
it all in
it's
there.
My, what do you think I'm gonna do? Put this shit in my beard?
It's
just
like
walk
a
around,
really light,
go to store, got shit in my beard.
Very natural, you know. Base wash.
It is a little weird because it's not like soap. It is just like kind of a.
It's kind
like
of a creamy sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Maybe you just left a little bit in. That's what I was asking. But yeah, it's really good. What was the other question?
Shampoo.
Everybody has different skin types. So just because it works for me and Max doesn't mean it's going to work
that's
for you.
That's true. I have very sensitive skin, believe it or not. I really do.
Yeah. I believe it.
Yeah. I'm a sensitive.
We're learning
person.
A lot about each other.
This is great. This is great conversation. This is fantastic. Max.
Over at Morgan and wondering,
I know.
Like, do they do this all the time? Like, who
he's
are
like, people? God, I'm so glad I don't have to be here.
This just happens, Morgan. Sometimes
no,
I'll go off on weird
most,
tangents.
It's like beauty centric discussion I've ever had on. Any type of like video game show at all.
We talk about all.
And I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're comfortable with our masculinity.
I don't think enough dudes talk about, you know, like what products do you use, guys? Huh?
Yeah.
We once spent like a good 20 minutes before a show talking about jeans, stretch jeans.
Morgan, do you know about stretch jeans, by the way? I wear stretch jeans.
Totally like redo this one.
Yeah. I wear stretch jeans all across the board.
I'm interested in still trying stretch jeans, but they look like regular jeans, apparently.
They
JP,
do.
I don't know.
They're the best.
That sounds like an amazing thing, like to just look like you came with the proper attire, but really you're wearing pajamas pretty much on the inside.
Pretty much.
That sounds amazing.
It's like the tuxedo t-shirt, you know? You want to look nice, but you don't want to try too hard.
Good tuxedo
t-shirt.
I just see nothing.
Room. Yeah.
I just see nothing but judgment in Morgan's eyes.
No, well, okay. Women's jeans all have stretch. Like 100% of women's jeans have stretch in them because they're tight, and otherwise you wouldn't be able to actually like, sit down.
That's true.
Yeah.
So you can purchase non-stretch jeans, but they're not cute. I was taking like a welding class, and you can't have any synthetic fibers in your clothes, I guess, because they will catch on fire.
Yeah.
So like I had to buy men's pants. For that. So that's why I was surprised that men's jeans even have stretch in them. Like that's an available option.
You have to like seek them out. It's not all.
I think
it's not a common thing.
Most denim, most like store-bought kind of non-raw selvage like denim has some degree of stretchiness to it.
Yeah.
Because people are used to sizings with little bit of like flexibility, and like actual like raw denim jeans have none of that, and they can be super uncomfortable. You got to break them in, and there's a whole thing.
Oh yeah, if I wear non-stretch jeans, they just feel like terrible. I don't even want to
freak at them.
They're the worst.
You wear
it's
them
just sandpaper
for like a year, and then they're perfect.
Yeah,
my skin is sensitive, as I said earlier.
Yeah, that's real sensitive. That's why I wear. Look, it's either stretch jeans or MeUndies. It's one of those two. The most comfortable pants in the world. You got to go with both.
I didn't know they made pants.
That's
lounge pants. I'm wearing them right now. I got lounge pants on. They're fantastic. Do you know what MeUndies are?
You are where I was at, Morgan, like about a week or two ago. He said this, and I was like, I thought they just had underwear.
We've talked about this now.
What?
Rehash these conversations.
Every guest, I've just got to sell them on stretch jeans, MeUndies, and ask them what type of shampoo
they use. We didn't even finish the shampoo round off.
We didn't. Max said fucking Kalamazoo.
I'm pretty sure what I have is, I think it's like Paul Mitchell shit I got from
designer shampoo.
I don't know. Maybe. It's in a green bottle. I think it's Paul Mitchell. I don't know. I grabbed it from, I think my girlfriend was at Ulta, and I got it there.
Wait, what's Ulta?
So, you know what Ulta is?
No. What is, I don't know what Ulta, is that like a fashion store or something?
I guess, you know, why would you know what Ulta is? Adam, Dan, or Morgan, you probably know what Ulta
is. Why are you tossing it to them? Just explain.
I'm curious. I'm surveying the rest to see, where you stand in this.
It's like a beauty supply place.
Here in Texas, we have Sally's Beauty Supply.
It's a Sally's Beauty Supply. Okay. But I've never seen an Ulta. I don't know where they are.
I also didn't know if it might be like a regional kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it's basically just a beauty supply thing. And they also have like hair products and all that shit. So. It's actually pretty cool if you're into that kind of thing and you want to have like decent stuff.
Yeah,
I got a good moisturizer. Maybe you could look into that. Does it dry out easily?
What, my skin?
Yeah, this is not like I'm making fun of you. I'm actually asking.
I don't think so.
Oh, all right. Well,
I don't use any moisturizer or anything. So
yeah, you should.
I don't like an oily. I hate an oily face, man.
You need to wear sunscreen though.
Yeah.
That's Morgan, like I don't know if you know about this. I don't go outside.
Okay, I don't either. This room, if you notice, has literally no windows in it. And everybody's like, let's go to the beach. And I'm like, I'm good. I think
I don't have the company of friends that say, let's go to the beach. That's not a thing that's said in my circle of friend.
But even if you like go outside, walk to your car, go to the grocery store, like you still should have sunscreen on.
I only go out at night.
Okay, then you're good.
I actually don't.
You don't want to get that moon burn.
I have to take vitamin D every day because I don't go outside. That's where I'm at right now.
Morgan, do you like apply sunscreen every time before you go outside?
Oh, absolutely. And I bring sunscreen with me.
That's crazy. That's not smart that you're crazy, but I've just never heard of that. A lot of
foundation has like UV stuff in it.
Yeah. I know a lot of makeup has that. Is that what you're talking about? Or do you specifically have like...
No, I mean, I put on... My skin is very light and I
have I was gonna say
cancer in my family. But
that makes sense.
Also would say that sun damage is the number one cause of aging. And so, you know, like it's just really, it's good. Like you'll thank yourself.
The thing is, I want to look like Gandalf as soon as possible. So I just lie in the sun as
just
long
like
as I
go
can.
Outside.
Up into
it's
it.
Like I'm already practicing the voice in private.
Christopher Lee, fucking Gandalf, whatever. I just want to look as much like a wizened old creature as possible. So I don't fuck with that sunscreen. That's not my game. I'm not about that.
Yeah, no, that's all I do is the sunscreen. And I think because I had so much, like, I was never that girly girl. And I had so much over the years of, like, being on TV and having, like, 8 pounds of fake hair and, like, 17 fake eyelash strips and all that shit. Yeah. Like, now that I'm not doing that anymore, I'm just like, fuck it. Like, I can't get excited about, like, getting my hair done and whatever. So I use whatever shampoo they have on the shelf that looks interesting to me that day. And...
go buy shampoo every day?
Whatever, the day that I am in the store.
Okay, all right. We had to clarify.
We're not all like you, Jake.
We didn't want people to think you're just spending your fortune.
Wait, am I doing it wrong?
JP's just such a baller. He'll just buy a thing of shampoo, use it once, and throw it out. I'm like, nah, give me a new one. It's cool.
Yeah.
I'm not laughing because it's actually true.
I know.
Shampoo on every surface in his house.
Yeah, that'd be great.
That's what's behind the screen right now, is just like shampoo.
Yeah, the shampoo. It's just, two IKEA shelves that are just filled with shampoo on each one. Just one bottle per little shelf. We don't share shelves. You can't have them next to each other. The scents will get mixed. Adam, what shampoo do you use? I'm just waiting
for the next question. Oh, there you go. Yeah.
I don't actually use like a wet shampoo usually because my hair is dyed and I want to like.
Oh, this get is it interesting. I want to talk about dry shampoos.
Yeah, so dry shampoo.
So usually I will just like wash it with like cold water if it's feeling like greasy. But yeah, I dry shampoo most of the time.
So how does this dry shampoo stuff work? Is it just like a paste?
There's two vectors of delivery, right? One is that it's like you can get it in like an aerosol can like hairspray, which I don't really fuck with that. And then like basically dry shampoo is basically just like baking soda or baking powder or whatever. It's the like just a dry material, and then sometimes it's scented. Like the stuff I have is kind of like citrus scented. And you just like put it in your hands and like rub it in your hair, and then just like shake it all out so you're not like leaving dust clouds.
Do you have to like blow dry it out?
No, you can just shake it or comb it out if you comb your hair. My hair is kind of curly, so I don't. But yeah, you just shake it out, and then it just absorbs some of the natural like greasiness oil of the human head. And it works great, and it makes my hair all like poofy, and it lightens it a little bit because it's white, right? So it works with the color that I have, but it's not for everybody. It really depends. You got to kind of try it out.
Oh, it's the best thing ever.
I really like it. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Because you can just like you do little touch ups or yeah.
So then, do you shower cap when you shower, Adam, or do you like how does?
No, I just like put my hair up and keep it out of the way.
It's not like a total. It's not shampoo. It's not like a total replacement for kind of like a half-ass wash. It's more like so if you have any part that's like a little oily, it makes it not oily.
Okay.
But like eventually you do have to like.
I might actually get some dry shampoo. I'm very intrigued now.
I've seen like Amanda uses dry shampoo, and it is the aerosol type, and that's always kind of made me like, is that the type of shit we're gonna find out like 5-10 years from now? Like, yeah, anyone who used dry shampoo, you're fucked.
No, it's been around for a really long time.
Yeah, I've only recently come across it just because. I never really saw. Yeah, but it's very common with like color treated hair, as far as I understand. Just because
That's why I started using it because coloring your hair is tedious and expensive, and if you want it to last longer, you just don't shampoo it with like.
I love that I'm having this conversation with men right now because women know, like every woman out there is like, it's miserable, it's tedious, like you're constantly figuring out like which shampoos to use. I mean, you could probably do like one of those. Lavender, like the anti-yellowing shampoos, like it's just
anti-yellowing shampoo.
Oh, girl, I know all the tricks. Like, I put the color that I use, I put it in a like a white conditioner. I mix it in there so that when I condition my hair, it reapplies the dye. I know how to do that shit.
Yeah,
I'm all
right,
about
you're
it.
Good.
Yeah, yeah.
I actually knew that as well. I don't color my hair as might be evidence. Actually, my normal hair color is yellow.
That's blonde. True.
I dye all the time.
Max, here's a real question. When you start getting gray hairs, which I don't know if that happens in your family, but
already happening.
Okay, would you dye your hair or beard?
I've kind of made peace with like the salt and pepper that's been happening like here.
Yeah.
And I don't even think that's probably just like a mix of maybe stress and then aging. But I'm not too concerned with it. I used to be like, oh fuck, like when I started seeing grays, I'm like, god damn it, this sucks.
Yeah, I don't care.
I think
anymore.
The only thing I don't want right now is just like a lot of gray in the beard. There's like a couple grays in there. I'll just pluck that shit out and like get the fuck out of here.
If it's like a lame gray or like a silver platinum type gray, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I think if it got real bad, like too soon, and like hair wise, if I just started like going like holy shit, like for some reason I just got really stressed out and it just started accelerating a lot, maybe I'd dye my hair. But I mean, that's always an option, and I don't feel like
generally.
The problem with that though.
Sorry, go ahead. I was just gonna say that generally speaking, this the gray hair thing, like if you are a dude. It's much more socially acceptable to just kind of leave it and be like, yeah,
oh, yeah.
I'm looking distinguished.
A little totally. Wise at my
age. Yeah, so
it's
way easier to just be like, eh, whatever, cool. I got some gray hairs. I look all distinguished. Maybe I'm going to change my look a little bit to revolve around the gray hair. So we don't have that pressure to like, and also it depends on your complexion too. Like depending on the way you are like personally colored, gray hair can look good or bad.
Yeah.
Accordingly.
My dad had full gray hair when he was a senior in high school. So I thought it was going to be like 20.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
When I was full gray, and it just it hasn't happened. And I'm kind of upset because he has like platinum silver hair that looks badass. So I would look like a Jay Leno without the skunk, basically.
That's what I'm saying. I feel like if I did have like some crazy platinum silver hair like your dad, I'd probably just roll with it. I'd just be like, all right.
Yeah,
I'm at this stage.
If your hair is dark and then you start dyeing it, the gray, and then you decide that you want to stop dyeing it, now you have this.
Oh,
like,
it looks weird as
the
shit.
Line. Yeah. So in a way, like if you have dark hair, like you shouldn't start it.
Yeah, I had a friend who had gray in his beard. He dyed all of his head black, like all of his hair black, and it was like a light brown. He looks ridiculous. absolutely ridiculous.
I don't feel like I have to do that anytime soon. It would have to be like something.
I don't
crazy,
know, Max.
Like,
you're like
some
26
weird ass
now,
fucking so. Gray like mismatch kind of thing. But it's been pretty evenly, you know, salt and peppered. So I'm okay with that.
What about a streak? Would you rock a streak?
I don't know.
I would never rock
a streak. Look good.
I think a streak looks ridiculous. I think if you have a streak, you're trying. I think that's just a big signal that you're trying.
Next show, JP, this swoop right here is just going to be a fucking gray streak.
That would be the best.
I did. You can go get that. It's Sally's Beauty Supply. When I was in high school, I'd buy the colored spray. So I would have like blue hair and go to school to piss off the principals and stuff. It's great. It's fantastic. So just go get that, Max. Let's go buy that. Good different stuff. Also, I looked at dry shampoo names. These are some great shampoo names. We've got Batiste, Living Proof, TG, Redken. Everyone knows Redken. Dry Bar. There's one called Cake. I should just buy Cake.
Do that.
It's $18.
Report
though.
Back.
Shampoo can get expensive when it gets designer.
It lasts a long time, though.
Maybe. There's one called Philosophy. I should just get that. That's a great name.
And I love this. I love going to like a beauty supply store, even just like a drugstore, and looking through the aisle at the ways in which companies try to make men feel more comfortable about buying traditionally female like beauty products.
Yeah.
But they're like tweezers for men, and you're like, it's cool.
Yeah. What the fuck?
They're tweezers, yo. Like. They'll put
pluggers.
Them in like black bottles and give them like cool names. Like,
well, the other thing that's crazy about shampoo bottles is they've gotten crazy with these bottles. There's all types of bottles now for shampoo. Some of them are fucking real rad. Some of them are real boring though. Don't buy the boring shampoo bottles. You got to buy the crazy like square ones that are super slim and like real tall and shit, so they don't fit anywhere in your bathroom because no one has a fucking spot for something that's that tall in your bathroom. It's great. You gotta buy that.
But you're just paying for the bottle at that point.
I'm okay with that.
Don't forget, JP is a connoisseur of the shampooing arts. Yeah. He's reading it for the articles.
I am. I do read the sides sometimes just to see what.
You have way better shampoo than I have, I'm sure.
My girlfriend buys better shampoo than I do. I'll say that much. I have like, what is it? Isn't there like horse shampoo or something like that?
Oh, yeah, Mane and Tail.
We have a bunch of Mane and Tail, which I think is like the most expensive shampoo that we own.
Two horse products that people enjoy, shampoo and tranquilizers.
Yeah, exactly. All right, well, that's 25 minutes of alienating Dan here at the start of the show. So let's just move on.
Dan, how do you trim? How do you go about an attack trimming your?
Let's just move on. Let's just go to D&D.
A+ pre-show, everybody. Good work. Nice stuff.
I did every now and then, like glance up, just Dan's like.
I spend most of that. Yeah.
Problems I do not have.
So before we get started though, on the community site, Zyron, a fan, did some math for us, going back to like week 11, I think, checking on the XP of the party because there's some discrepancies. Dan suddenly overtaking Max didn't make sense to Zyron, so they went back and they checked every time I gave out experience.
That's nuts.
Big ups to you, Zyron. So there's some minor adjustments that need making. I accidentally gave you the kobold fight experience twice, and Berg, you shorted yourself 400 experience on week 27 due to some bad math. Berg and Azriel are missing some experience. Anyways, Iron did all this math. So Berg, your total XP at the beginning of the last session, and nobody got any XP last session because I gave it out accidentally. Your XP right now should be 6,502.
Which puts me in level 5.
You're level 5.
Yep. Azriel's, yours should be 6,209. And Black Gale and Nakana Ino both need to reduce your XP by 188. Okay. And then we're math wise, we're fixed. So yeah, thank you.
So 6502 is what you said?
You are at, yes, yeah, 6502.
What's the next level?
Your next level?
6? I'm not sure.
Oh, well, 6.
I mean, yeah.
Let me go look.
I was saying experience wise.
I think it's like 7. Level 6. Oh, no. Holy shit. Level 6. Max, take some guesses here. We haven't.
I'm gonna say like 9,000 something, maybe 10,000.
14,000.
Jesus. Well, actually, no. It does make sense if it scales up and up and up. Yeah. Okay.
You're about halfway there. Yeah.
Man, you get fucking. So is he in this fight at level 5, or we're gonna do it after the fight?
We'll do it on the next rest. Yeah.
Okay. You get a lot of stuff, Max.
Cool.
Yeah, this level 5 is the first proficiency bonus tier up. So basically, you'll get a +1 to every roll you make. That is when you have proficiency and everything. We'll talk about it when you get a chance to rest.
We got to get out of this fight first.
Yeah. So right,
guys,
now,
what if we just got on our horses and ran?
No, because we need to get Chuckles.
Oh fuck! Yeah, that's
Chuckles.
Right.
We do need to get Chuckles. Yeah, yeah.
I have a divine quest to avenge Chuckles. Right?
Yeah. Yeah. So at the very end of the last fight, Chuckles was killed by veteran soldiers, reduced back into elephant statue form, and is currently a very many meters away from you. Is like kind of all the way across the battle.
If they fucking take Chuckles and run, I'm gonna be so pissed.
Yeah, but 250 feet away from all y'all. However, the advantage you have is that you have a sorcerer with a distance spell situation going on. So, Nakana, you know, there are no targets near you unless you want to get revenge on that horse that kicked you in the face.
Shatter him. Oh, shit.
They are.
Oh, I was like, the horse?
No, not the horse.
Don't you remember?
I mean, you could do that. He did fight you. If you're that pissed off at him, I guess you could.
Yeah, no. But my shatter, I can only get up to 120 feet, and they are,
they're like 180.
They're
220 away
have,
from Berg. 225 from Berg.
I think I can do...
You have Expeditious Retreat.
Move, exactly. I think I can do 60 feet of running.
High speed snake lady.
Damn.
Yeah.
That was some great planning ahead right there. Fortuitous.
Tactical genius.
100%. Totally on purpose. Okay.
Expeditious Retreat allows you to take a bonus action. It allows you to take a bonus action at the end of your turn. So you won't be able to move and battle them this turn.
Well, that's dumb.
Well, what if we send action, the owl to poison the well, Adam? What if that...
it's until the spell ends. First, it's just a bonus action. It was just the first round as a bonus. So yeah, so go ahead. You can do your move action. You can take a bonus to move again, and then you can cast the spell. Yep, you're okay this turn.
Oh, okay.
It's just that it's the first turn you cast it.
Also, Adam, will Shatter break the figurine?
Might. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Are magical items broken so easily? I mean, I would imagine it.
The only thing that you can really do to damage an item is use magic to damage it, and that's what this is.
Yeah,
it
Max, let me talk to you about an orb I once broke.
Specifically, non-magical objects also take the damage, but I'm going to give it a saving throw to see if it's damaged. I think it is possible. This is they're a pretty big spell. It's a big explosion. I think there's a chance you could hurt it.
Well, I mean, either we have Chuckles or nobody does. So
that's the truth.
Yeah.
Okay, but I can only move. I can't get close enough. I think I can only get. I think the closest I can get is like 200 feet.
Yeah, you'll have to move.
It's still pretty far. Yeah.
Yeah, you have to go a second time.
I mean, I can do Scorching Ray.
How many distance spells do you get? Do you have 2 sorcery points or whatever? right?
I have 3 sorcery points.
Yep. Oh, okay. All right. Cool.
So I can do Scorching. Yeah. So okay, this one I can do. I'll move closer and then I'll do Scorching Ray. So I will start doing. Is it my turn? Actually, it's a great question.
It is definitely.
Okay. Yep. Yeah. Cool.
You're at the top of the order.
Okay. Cool. So I will move. Now I'm at this corner here. Do I have to move down first?
Yes. Yeah. Move down and then run west.
Show your character.
Okay. So now I can move.
Move another. If you do your bonus action and you're moving, you move another 55 feet from where you are. Which would put you here.
Sorry, I'm getting there.
It's okay.
There, and then I'm going to do another 30 feet. Mm-hmm. So I will be over here with my friend.
Expeditiously.
Expeditiously.
And up over there.
Technically, it's expeditious retreat, but, you know. Okay.
And retreat now I'm gonna to battle.
Yeah, you're retreating. You're going to the retreat of their death. It's great.
I mean, the horse that you was behind you did just kick you and kill you.
Yeah.
You're retreating. The most dangerous thing in this fight so far.
Okay. And then so now I want to see if I can get. Ooh, I can. I want to go for the hobgoblins.
The hobgoblins are gone. These are just veteran soldiers. But yeah, they're tougher than the guards in the front.
Then maybe I'll just do. What do you guys think? Veterans or soldiers? I can hit 3 of them.
You might. They had 15 health, so you might be able to one-shot the little guards.
Probably, yeah, the little ones, just because they have...
You don't have to choose them all at once. You could take a shot, decide another one, take a shot, decide another one.
Oh,
you can
do. Right. I would say go for whichever one is going to pick up the figurine.
Yeah, so whoever's closest, which would be the little guards.
Okay, cool. So I'll do Scorching Ray.
24.
That's not bad.
And this was against one of the guards?
Yes.
Doesn't that do good damage?
Yeah, sorry. I'm getting there.
Okay.
It's not great.
All right. So it scorches, but does not kill that person.
The one that's hot. Closest to
Son of a bitch.
It's so hot. I didn't bring my sunscreen like Morgan's.
He suddenly becomes withered and old. Gross.
Sunspots everywhere. Yeah.
No one likes him. His charisma drops to 2. All right, finish the sucker off. You want to shoot the same guy?
So I'm going to shoot the same guy.
Okay. Scorch him again.
Woo!
Do you have to recast the spell?
Yeah, you got to reroll to hit. So roll to hit again. And then,
because they're
3 separate rays.
Okay.
Okay, that second ray misses, unfortunately.
25! I hate that sometimes, just seeing that.
Yeah. What a crit! You got one more ray.
God damn it.
Oof. Oh, a 9. No. All right.
Damn it.
So ineffective, unfortunately. Heat beams just fly out there. The first one hits him, and then he throws himself to the side, and you scorch the ground near him. To no avail. Okay. The blue guard drakes are both dead, so they don't get a turn. Azrael, it is your turn. What would you like to do?
Okay.
Very long ass way.
So far away from anything.
Yeah.
Can we get an HP check on everyone, by the way?
That's a good point. Hold on. Before you take your turn, there is a bless spell in effect on Nakana Ino. So if you want to roll your D4s for those, you certainly can. We haven't rolled anything else, so.
Oh, right, for bless, yeah.
For Scorching Ray, for that second one at least, don't bother rolling for the third one, but roll 12, a D4 and add it to the 12.
What is it? Slash roll D4?
Slash R space 1D4.
Yeah, or just D4.
Or D4, right? Yeah, okay.
Because there's a chance. Oh. No. Okay. So bless exists, but didn't help. Okay.
Fuck.
Anyway, Azrael.
Okay. I will run with the rest of the party. I can't really do anything from where I am.
Running right straight at him, though, is just so... Yeah.
I'll go back for us.
I'm so worried about them just pelting us just like fucking chuckles with arrows.
Yep.
Yeah, my fear is that they're just going to pick that thing up and run, though.
Yeah, I know. Right.
Like, if we don't give
them
a target...
Over here. As far as I can go.
Okay. All right. So the guards... Yeah, I mean, the guy that got zapped definitely picks up the marble elephant. I'm going to make a note of which one it is.
Motherfucker.
Well, it's a suicide mission, guys. Let's go.
And then he runs for it. He grabs the elephant, jams it in his pocket, and runs off.
That bastard.
Yeah.
Well, we don't see him elephant. Go that way, so... Wait, do we see him turn to the right?
Yeah, you see him turn and go around the corner, but then he disappears once he runs around the corner.
He's so fucking gone. We're so far away.
The other three, they're going to fire their crossbows, probably. I think it'll be a disadvantage. Yeah, disadvantage. So three shots against Nakano Ino at disadvantage.
It's been awesome, guys.
Good luck.
It's okay.
Thank you.
Your AC's 15, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. First shot, disadvantage. That's a miss. Second shot, also a miss, just barely. And then the third shot, also same thing. So they're firing outside their good range. The corals are landing at your feet. One quite, or I guess you don't have feet. They're landing at your tail. and you're fine. And then I think that they fall back around the corner so they don't present an obvious target. And no one has line of sight on them, so they disappear. Jubilant Black Gale, it is your turn.
So I stated at the end of last episode that I'm at the top of this tree. How tall is this tree? How far up in the air am I?
I'm like 15 feet. 15 yeah, give feet. Or take.
Okay. Yep. How tall are these houses?
10 feet tall, maybe a little more.
You should be able to see them.
They slope at the top, so.
So.
But you can land on them. They have like rough kind of thatched roofs.
I can't see where this guy's heading though. I just know that he ran to the
north or the east. Yeah, they all ran into an alley amid the tallest buildings, so you can't really see where they are. You'd have to be on top of those buildings.
Okay.
This building is two stories.
Which one?
The
one in front of me?
And so is this one. No, the
ones in the back?
One. Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah. This guy and the one to the left of it.
Okay.
That guy realistically is gone. He's just going to he's literally leaving. He's just going to fucking sell that thing and live like a king.
All right. Well, I'm going to move. I'm going to make the dash action and fly 60 feet up to the house in front of us right here.
Did we actually know how much that elephant thing is worth? It's got to be a pretty good amount.
No.
Depends on where you sell it. Yeah.
It's cool, you guys. We're going to get it back. Don't worry about it.
When I get up here, can I make a perception check or anything to see if I see that guy, or do I just not see him?
Oh, you definitely can't see him. There's a big ass like wall of building over here.
Okay.
Blocking your line of sight.
And then for this building up here, I think that's the eastmost building, because you said north was the left side of the map.
Yeah, north is on the left. So yeah. East, like this one here.
Does this building end eventually?
Yes, it ends. It ends right at the end of the map.
Okay, I'm staring at the end of that because I saw that guy go there. So I'm looking for a horse or a guy fleeing outside the eastern.
From here, I think make an investigation check.
Okay. Great.
Okay, you can't spot anybody from up here. Yeah, they're all not in a place where you can see them.
All right.
All right, Berg. Your Berserker Rage will end this turn if you don't attack someone or take damage, so.
I guess I just run at them. Fuck it.
Well, yeah, there's only two left.
Possible. I think you might run. Yeah, I think the Rage might end.
Any javelin them? Do you have any javelins?
I do have a javelin. I'm just trying to remember. I don't use it very often. What's the range on a fucking javelin?
It's really low. It's like 36.
I don't think it's very far at all. I have a blowgun.
That's even worse. 3120. So you could throw a javelin if you're within 120 feet of.
Can you throw a Can you throw a blowgun at me?
I could.
Oh, taking one for the team, guys.
Where's that fucking horse?
Oh yeah, the horse. That fucking horse.
The horse just like nervously peeks up.
I think I'm just gonna lose my rage and have to go into another one. But.
Yeah, remember, as soon as you drop out of your rage, you take that level of exhaustion.
Level of exhaustion, yeah. Well, I guess the question is, we're giving chase, right? Because
we got to get chuckles.
We have to, yeah.
Yeah.
So my maximum movement is what? 60 feet if I move twice? Right?
Yes.
30. Where can we get to? God, my movement sucks ass.
30 feet is the exact normal movement for all things your size.
I still hate it, though. I just when you're presented with a scenario like this, I don't know.
Normally you're fighting in enclosed, like, dungeon rooms. This is a quite a large...
Do these guards have the same sort of movement, or are we not allowed to know that? I feel like
things, an average, like, human-sized thing has 30 feet of movement.
Okay. Maybe my perspective on it just skewed. Would this put me in cover, then? Somewhere in here, like, partial cover?
Yeah, you can run and take cover. I'm gonna go up here.
Plop.
I also think this is like the first time we've had a fight this large of a map before.
Yeah, this huge. Well, we did engage a town, like, you know, at the entrance of it. So yeah, it kind of makes sense.
Okay, so you run up, you lose your rage, but you take cover, and you're just like behind this like clustered bush, and just like breathing really hard. You can feel your heart pounding in your chest, and all of the strength kind of saps out of you. So you have one level of exhaustion, which means disadvantage on basically anything that's not an attack roll or a saving throw.
Yeah.
Disadvantage on ability checks.
Second level of exhaustion is when it's half my health.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah. Okay. So hobgoblins are still doing stuff. The veterans who have heavy crossbows.
The other option... Oh, shit. We have horses behind us. Why don't we just get on a fucking horse?
So the heavy crossbow is a range of 100, 400. So let's see if they can get within 100 feet of Berg. Berg has cover.
One of our horses went in with those demon horses, looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got to get all demonized.
I'm a demon
horse now.
We're going to talk to him about Satan and stuff. He's going to be like, oh,
exactly. We're going to get
they're
back.
They're bad influence on your horses. Yeah, you look over and they're all smoking horsey. Cigarettes.
He's going to neigh.
He's listening to rap music. It's a bad time. They've stopped going to church.
He's just got a leather jacket on. We're like, what the fuck?
Totally. Just they've become to become.
I don't serve you anymore. Tell him, guys.
Amazing. Okay, so these two veterans move up as an action, and then they're both going to take a shot at disadvantage at Nakane Ino, because she's the most out in the open.
God damn it.
So,
it's fine.
Veterans.
I'm not there to heal you. It's good. Dan's there, though. Dan can do something this
Again, at disadvantage. First shot, miss. Whew. And second shot, so miss. Ow. Okay, yeah, so they can't. You're getting shot at like crazy, but you're too far away for their effective range. Okay, your turn.
I'm getting out of the way.
Okay.
So I am going to go, I think I'm going to head north to try to stop them, and I'm going to go behind this tree.
Okay.
And that's, let's see, right here. And then I can't really do anything else from here, I guess. So I guess that's my turn.
Yeah, you can't really see anybody.
I'm kind of,
Yeah, okay. Asriel?
Let's see. Kind of in an odd spot. Let's see. I think it'd be safer for me to go around the backside instead of the front, because they'll get shots at me otherwise. So I'm going to run back. Back here, run and dash to the back of the building with everyone else.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. Okay. Jubilant, your turn. What are you going
to
do?
I'm asking chat to do some math for me.
You're trying to triangulate? Yeah.
Wait. So if I didn't take an action, doesn't that mean I get three? Because I can take...
Oh, yeah. You move, and then you moved, then you dashed with Expeditious Retreat, and then you have an action. Was there something else you wanted to do?
But as my action, I can't use that as a move a third time, right?
Yeah, you can move again.
I'm sorry to totally have hijacked this.
No,
my only thought is like, do you think you guys think it's safe for me to move up more though?
I'm going to next round. Yeah, I think as long as you don't like cross this area right here, this line.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's fine.
As long as there's a building between you and them, you should be fine.
Yeah. Oh, God. Adam, I can't. Never mind.
So maybe, I mean, I could go up to like, maybe I just go up.
Yeah.
Go behind the well.
Go check out the well. Maybe you're curious about where the owl is.
Yeah.
All right. I'm moving to the well. And I will at some point spit in it with my poison spit.
Yeah. Fuck that.
Like 100%. It's going to happen. I guess right there. Okay. Okay, carry on, gentlemen. Thank you.
You slip okay. over a vial that's just there for some reason.
Oh, God.
Awesome. Okay, so, you move over towards the well. What's your passive perception?
Let's see. 11.
Okay, all right. Cool. So, Jubilant, what are you going to do?
Now that I've been flying for a while. You know, I'm getting used to it. We're at the flying squirrel levels of flying, so I just kind of thrust myself towards an area and slam into it. I don't, like, make a graceful landing yet. I'll make the dash action over to this building right here.
Okay. Flying to you for that building.
Sure. As I'm, like, in the middle, I want to... Can I see anyone fleeing the town on a horseback or anything like that? As I have maybe I'm at the peak of my flight.
Your arc.
Yeah, of my arc.
Make an investigation check.
God damn it.
No, you definitely can't.
5, 6, 7, 8. Next is 9 and 10. We'll get there someday, boys.
All right, Berg, what are you going to do?
Berg is going to move up over yonder to, let me mark it off for you, this spot.
Okay.
Looks like I should have line of sight cover. Let me make sure again. I know where I'm going. Yep, right there. Okay, cool. And whop.
Pew. Okay, so move. Okay. Yep. So you don't have like soft cover from the bushes, but I see what you're doing with like
elements. Yeah, you just line of sight cover.
Okay. So yeah, forcing the veterans to move to be able to get a bead on you because they can't see neither of them can see past the
top. If nothing else, I'll just tank some fucking damage here.
So let me see if this one can. Yeah, there you go. So he'll move there. And this one.
You're gonna get shot, Max.
Yeah, I know.
Aren't you full HP though?
I'm full HP. I'm not enraged, so I am going to take full damage if they hit me, but I haven't even used my racial ability.
So one. Wait, did we one
skip?
Heavy crossbow?
No, we didn't skip Dan. Never mind.
One heavy crossbow shot on Berg.
That's a crit.
That's 17 damage.
Of course
damage.
He would crit this. Of course he would crit it.
So it's as they're running up, yeah, the veteran gets the shot, beats on you, fires, and you and the quarrel intersect. And
I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, he's still got to get through my 18 AC.
You're at half HP now. Fucking Christ.
Okay, yeah, so you take that hit, and it's not pleasant.
Do I have another shot coming if I wait?
And then the veteran finishes his move. Yeah, that one's up there. Okay, good.
Right.
Nakana Ino, it is your turn.
I think I'm just going to move to behind the building.
Go to the corner?
To the corner, yeah.
Sure.
None of this would have happened if I was level 5. I would be a god!
Well, I would have built the encounter differently.
Yeah, I know.
Okay,
what's just north of this? Like, I can't see it on the map. Like, just north of this building right here?
Like, east of this? Because north is this way?
Yeah, or just like, what's up above?
That's north,
the direction that I'm pointing, or this way?
No, like this way. I don't know.
Northeast.
Basically nothing. Yeah, everything outside of there, there's maybe like a slight area around on that end that is cut away, but it's mostly jungle. And then you can see slightly this way, like maybe 200 feet to the east. There's the low stone forge building that they built, and you can just see like smoke coming up out of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you move. Do you want to do anything else? Because your expedition.
I might just like. I'm still in cover, but I have a little more flexibility. Okay, I'm good.
Okay. All right, Azriel.
All right, I'm going to haul ass as fast as I can. Over.
Never mind.
What?
Your owl's not summoned, right? We didn't resummon your owl before we joined this fight.
Actually, I had plenty of time because we waited like all night, so I could have summoned it again.
Had time, yes. Could have, yes. Did.
I just forgot of. Okay, let's...
I forgot of.
Yeah.
I like it.
I English very well.
I spack it good.
Look, Dan, you had a rough first 30 minutes of the show.
I know. Okay. I'm just going to run over here with Nakina, just to protect her in case something happens. And I'll try to go around the backside.
Okay, you'll have to be in a square that's not her.
Okay,
but,
then yeah. I'll be right there then.
Yeah. Okay, perfect. All right, Jubilant Black Ale.
All right, I will move. How far is this? I'm gonna move 15 feet up to the top of this house, the apex of the roof.
And this would be difficult terrain, but you're flying, so you're just kind of hovering over the top of the roof.
Yeah, I want to get up there. Can I make an investigation check to see if I see anything from there?
I mean, you're looking into the side of these buildings, right? Because this is only one story, the one that you're on. So there's a big wall of building here.
Is this one in front of me still one story?
No, this is all one building, and it's two.
Okay. Well, I know that guy just took a shot of Max. So I moved 15, so I got another 45. Ooh, I can get... Yeah. Okay, I want to move...
And the other guy hasn't done anything, so he's probably got a readied shot, just to warn you.
Yeah, no, I'm aware of the readied shots. Is this area lower, Adam, than this? The building that I'm on. So, okay.
Yeah, yeah. The part you're on is the well, no, actually, this is all one story. So, no, it's not. It's just separated.
Just separated?
Yeah.
So that's okay. All right. I'm going to move here. I'm dashing, so I've moved 45 feet. If I get up to there, what do I see anything new?
I mean, you still can't see past this building. So if there's anything in the alley or whatever over here, you won't be able to see it until you're on top of these buildings. But from where you're standing, no, you don't. You just see the forge off to the east.
You said one story. One story is how many feet? 10?
10-ish.
10-ish? Okay.
Yeah, 10, between 10 and 15, depending on the building.
All right, I'm going to use my final 15 feet then to go up here to the north, and hopefully I don't get shot. I'm going to go right here.
Okay.
Right in the path.
Anything?
Did I see anything when I fly over?
No, because you're on the down part of the building. Yeah. Once you get up here, you'll be able to see.
Okay.
Okay. So the veterans. The one.
Veterans are going again before I go.
No. Yeah, sorry, I skipped you. Go ahead, Berg. I was like, why did they get to go again? Berg hasn't gone. Go.
Yeah. Okay. I don't think being in a rage right now would be good. I don't fucking know. I move up here and get in a cover. Mm-hmm. Do they still have line of sight there? If he moves
that would force them to move. Yeah.
Yeah. But do you have line of sight from here? Like that?
Because
I know there's been some trickery. He just might hit me.
No, but remember, line of sight is sort of irrelevant. He's so close, he would just do this. Step out, shoot, step back.
Shoot. Yeah.
Like y'all have been doing.
Maybe I fly into a rage. I don't know. Or move up and just... Yeah. That was my other thought. I forgot to fucking dodge last time.
Well, you didn't have the action. You moved twice.
Yeah, you dodged.
You're right. Yeah, actually, if you move... So I guess I could just move up 30 feet, dodge, and then see what happens. Or rage and, hook a javelin or a blow dart. Fuck. I think maybe raging might be a good idea, because we're going to get into a fight here. They don't seem like they're backing down.
You're also on your own, so any defensive...
I am on my own, yeah, so no one's here to fucking... No one's here to help me, so rage is...
If you go up there, rage, and don't make an attack, it goes away next round, doesn't it, Adam?
I know. Well, I can rage... Move up, throw it, and take an attack. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Unless they move to where you can't attack them, then it just goes away, because they could back up.
Yeah.
Well, but at that point,
they have missile. They have missile weapons, and they're combat veterans, and you have javelins and haven't thrown any yet. And if you run at them screaming, they will fall back and shoot you. Yeah.
Yeah.
They know not to get in a sword fight with you if they can.
They're just gonna keep falling back. So. I don't...
Yeah.
And we can lend some support. Like I can kind of come back here behind the house and use some projectile weapons on them. So it's not like you're totally on your own. Like we can get some of the way there.
Can I move up, dodge, and also hold action? No, I can't. Can I? Right.
Dodge is the action.
Dodge is the action. Oh, God damn it. I hate this.
Dodging would make it really hard for them to hit you. Like
really. It would, yeah. I'm just trying to decide rather. It seems stupid to take this full on, this frontal attack. I'm just being like a distraction really at this point, but for what purpose? Because that our goal is to get that guy that's running away. He's, I don't know. I'm basically either going to go around this way towards the back end and like try to, you know, be a little sneaky beak. Yeah. Or go up here, dodge. I think going around the back end probably is the best.
Only advice I could say is you're by yourself right now, so just be careful.
Yeah.
Careful play, I think, is in your best interest because we're not over there to help you. You have no heals. You actually have a healing potion now that I think about it, because we all have a healing potion that we never used.
Oh, well, that's true. Well, I'm not going to use it just quite yet. I'm going to go... Let's see. We can get to... What's 30... And then another 30. Okay. I think I'm going to get behind this building somewhere. Whatever spot I can get to there. So probably somewhere like is it possible for me to get there?
Yes.
Yeah, all right, cool. Let's just go there. And then I can dodge in case they get wise to me.
Was that just a 30-foot move?
No, that was 30 and then probably like not even the full.
Yeah, so you can't dodge. You can move, but not dodge. All right, you can throw yourself prone, I guess, but then if they run up on you.
Yeah. I don't want to do that. They're not going to come around the corner and do melee if they're veterans anyway, so I'm not really that worried about it.
Okay, cool. All right, let's have them.
They might run up and shoot, though.
Let's have them take their turn. So this one here sees Julian Gale up on the roof and then ducks around this corner so that he doesn't get Jubilant Black Galed.
That's what they call it.
You go over here, and he crouches down and takes cover back here. And then this guy, let's see. Let me see if he could see from here.
If you want to hide these guys, we can't see them, right, Adam?
Yeah, that's true. I don't think that guy, like, he doesn't have the movement to get around the corner to get at Uberg, so he falls. He's gonna fall back as well, and then I'll hide the two of them. Okay, all right. Nakanino, what are you gonna do? Turn into a street fight now.
Yeah. So if I'm trying to go, basically, let's see, I want to go to the north of this building so I can kind of like come around. So I can come around like on this side. Cause I'm trying to also find the guys. Like I'm trying to find Chuckles. Mm-hmm. So I can take my first move and move up here and then I can walk around the house and end up like, there's no square up there though. Like I want to end up above the map where the map is.
Yeah. Basically, assume that the above the map here is just empty space. Like you can run around.
So
up I can there.
Kind of, so like I'm behind the house basically right now.
Okay. You're like one square to the east of where you are on the map.
Okay. And now can I see anything when I poke down this alleyway?
Yeah. If you peer around the corner, you can see there's a hobgoblin here. Crouched behind that wall, holding a javelin. When you poke your head around the corner, he hucks it at you.
Yeah.
So let's see if he hits you with his javelin. Oh, sorry. These guys have longbows. So he's got a longbow pointed at the corner, and you come around the corner. And you just hear snap as he fires it at you.
Oh, boy.
I need to stop putting myself.
And his commander gives him a D4. If I roll a 4, he hits you. No, he just barely misses you. So it hits the wall next to you. And then you jump back behind the corner again.
Okay.
So you can see at least one target right there. He was hiding. And you can shout back to your friends where he was.
Okay.
Yep. So that was a move. How far did you move? You moved up 5 and then over 35, so that's 40 feet. So that's your move. You still have an action, though.
Oh, okay. Well, let me just... Let's see. He is...
You could shoot back at him before you duck back behind cover again.
Yeah, 35 feet. So I'm just going to use... let's see. I am just going to use good old-fashioned firebolt right now.
Okay, yeah. Firebolt his way.
Easy and free. Let's see, firebolt. I probably don't hit him.
No, you don't. Yeah. So you both, like, as he releases the arrow, you throw a firebolt, and the two of you duck back behind the corner, and the walls take the shot. Yeah. Okay, cool. So you're back behind cover up there. Yep. Azrael, your turn.
I guess I'm going to... let's see. Move as far as I can, but as close to knocking as I can get while dashing.
Okay, so the two of you are both one.
Oh, she has bless.
The, yeah.
If it matters.
Square to the east.
It probably doesn't, though, because he has higher than 15 AC.
Yeah, no, bless. Let me double check. No, don't bother rolling bless. Yeah, okay, cool. So we know where you are. You're done. So you're right behind her. Mm-hmm. It's tricky trying to keep up with someone who has twice your movement rate. Okay. So, guards, got them all accounted for.
I regret being by myself.
Yep.
I want to put that out there.
So, there are windows in this building to the left of you, Berg, and you see two guards with crossbows. One of them hits the window open, the other one fires his crossbow, and then the second one fires a crossbow at you.
Oh, that's mean.
There's just guys just in this fucking building?
Yes, there's guys in the building.
Uh-huh. Why didn't they come out before? Why are they waiting?
They were hiding.
Max, I would just say, if I could, let's just get out of here, just retreat.
Yep.
So, crossbow.
Do the old loop-de-loop
crossbow. Neither of them hit you. Yeah.
Or although, I could smash through the fucking window.
Although, you could just jump in there and say, what's up, bitches?
Totally. So they use their movement to pop up, fire at you, and then drop down behind the window again. So they disappear. And then Jubilant Black Gale, it is your turn.
But I have no idea of knowing how many fucking cards are in there is the thing.
That's true. That's very true. You do not
there also might be a dragon. Perhaps a dungeon. Who knows?
Exactly.
Yeah. They've actually dug a very deep pit in front of the window. You jump over and fall in. It's a whole Home Alone thing.
Yes, Chad, danger sense, but I didn't need to use it. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. I will move up 15 feet to the arc of this building. What do I see when I?
Okay. You can see there are two. you know, see the hobgoblin that Nakaino could see.
Yep.
There's another hobgoblin. Right here, down at the bottom.
Okay. They don't do anything to me.
The one down here, no, he's shouting orders to the others.
Okay. I only see those two hobgoblins, those two.
That's all you see. Yep.
Eebie-jeebies. All right. I would like to cast Spiritual Weapon then in front of, this one right here.
All right. I'm just switching. I have my guy switched around here.
Can we get a horn sound, please?
Oh, fuck. You get the horn out?
Yeah. Horn's coming out. The Horn of Gibraltar. Thank you.
Fantastic. Excellent work. Okay.
Thanks.
So I have it ready. Where do you want to place it? What square?
I don't know why that just rolled that. I was trying to show the spell. It's right here, right in front of the the easternmost goblin.
Okay. Boop. All right. It appears in front of him, the mighty Horn of Justice blasting in his face like a sweet rap mixtape. And I guess with that, maybe we take our break.
Yeah. God, I wasted a 22 roll.
No, you get to attack with it as you cast.
Oh yeah, that's
it,
right. So. Do your attack then. We'll
that's my roll then. 22. Ha. Yeah. I knew. I clicked it in advance and knew. Oh,
make the actual roll. You can't just roll a d20 on the table and the next time you want to take an action be like, there's my roll.
Actually, Adam, I can. Hey, it doesn't matter.
Hey,
all right.
Hey,
it doesn't
matter. Fuck you, Adam. All right. roll your damage.
Eight.
All right, so the hobgoblin grabs his head. He's like, as you blast him with your air horn. Boo, 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 boo. And he just grabs his head and roars in pain.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. That's the end of the turn.
Now let's
let's take our break there.
Yeah, let's take our first break. Still 3 hours left to go on Court of Swords. I hope we get Chuckles back. We'll find out if we do right after this. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.